Blackstone presents Psalms, an expositional commentary, Volume 3, Psalms 107 to 150, by James Montgomery Boice. This book is read by John Lescault. Preface. How time flies. I have often heard this adage, and believed it too, but it seems to be increasingly true as one grows older. It seems only yesterday that I began the writing of Psalms that comes to completion with the appearance of this volume. Yet I find on checking my records that I began this work in the winter of 1989. Since I finished preaching my last sermon on the Psalms in the summer of 1997, I realize that my study and writing on these great hymns of the Jewish and Christian Church have occupied my time for the better part of 8.5 years. What a time it has been! How worthwhile! I have been blessed in the work myself, discovering truths that I had not even begun to appreciate previously. I have also discovered that these studies have blessed many other people, as they were preached first to the congregation of 10th Presbyterian Church in Philadelphia, which I have served as senior minister for 30 years, and later to people across the country, as they were aired over the weekend edition of the Bible Study Hour, one of the radio programs now sponsored by the Alliance of Confessing Evangelicals. I am sure these sermons have been helpful, because the Psalms themselves speak so powerfully to the hurts, fears, disappointments, faith, hope, and spiritual aspirations of God's people. This third volume of Psalms contains expositions of the fifth and final book of the Psalter, Psalms 107 to 50. Volume 1 contained my studies of Book 1, Psalms 1 to 41, and Volume 2 contained my studies of Books 2, 3, and 4, Psalms 42 to 106. Two parts of this last section of the Psalter have been particularly important in the development of my own life and thinking, the first being Psalm 119, the massive psalm about the Bible. Psalm 119 is the longest chapter in the Bible, containing 176 verses, and nearly every verse, with few exceptions, mentions Scripture by one word or another. The psalmist refers to the Bible as God's law, statutes, ways, precepts, promises, decrees, commands, and words. He reflects on its importance to him in all circumstances and all moments of his life. The Bible was important in his youth, keeping him on track through life's many trials and disappointments. It was his textbook and God's school of discipleship. It gave great comfort, bore him up in times of affliction, taught him how to obey God, pray well, and walk by faith. Above all, it taught him to love the author of the book. All of us need all of these blessings also. In fact, so important are these fundamental lessons of how to live the Christian life through the study of the Bible that Baker Bookhouse, which publishes most of my writing these days, offered the 14 studies of Psalm 119 from this book in a special paperback volume entitled Living by the Book, The Joy of Loving and Trusting God's Word. Living by the Book appeared a year in advance of this volume in 1997. The second portion of this last book of the Psalter that has meant a great deal to me is the collection that follows the Songs of Ascents and closes the Psalter, Psalms 135 to 50. This section includes the final Psalms of David, Psalms 138 to 45. What is particularly striking about these last Psalms is that in one way or another, they all deal with worship. All the Psalms are intended for worship and have been used in worship throughout the ages. But these final psalms in particular teach us what true worship is, who should worship, and when and how we should praise God. I can think of few points of Bible teaching that are of greater importance for today's church, when worship of God in so many of our churches is at a low ebb. As in all my books, I want to thank the session and congregation of 10th Presbyterian Church for allowing me to spend so much of my time in Bible study and the writing of expository sermons. I also want to thank the staff of 10th Church, particularly the ministerial staff, who attend to many of the demands of a thriving church that I do not have time for personally. These friends free me up from much of my writing and speaking. I owe special thanks to Miss Joan Borgard, my executive assistant, who handled my schedule and carried out much of my work until her death last year. She is greatly missed. May these studies be a source of spiritual nurture, grace, comfort, and instruction as you read them. And may He who gave them to us for those ends bless you in your own study of the Bible.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.